Our Mayon Volcano Watch. State volcanologists warn the volcano could continue rumbling for months, possibly forcing thousands to remain in evacuation centers. Lava or red-hot rocks continue to ooze slowly from Mayon's crater. But PVOLC says there's been no significant increase yet in the level of sulfur dioxide emissions, volcanic earthquakes, and rockfall events at the volcano. Those parameters are being used in determining the appropriate alert level status for volcanoes. Mayon is currently under alert level 3.
Based on our previous experiences, this activity may persist for a few months. Kapag violent naman yung eruption niya, this would probably just take a few days to weeks. Pero kapag ganitong mabagal, it will probably take several months. Katulad ng 2018 eruption natin from January to March. And then yung 2014, ganun din, almost the same number of months.
Tributes continue to pour in for the late Philippine Senator and Armed Forces Chief Rodolfo Biazon. The esteemed statesman is remembered by his son, Muntinlupa Mayor Rufy Biazon, as a man dedicated to serving the Filipino people.
All his life, he's been facing death. He's always been putting his life on the line, ready to give it up. I realized that most likely, most especially in this condition, he was prepared for it. I grew up knowing him as somebody who's sharing his life with other people. I looked at it with admiration, because in our private moments when we talk about work, because I'm also into the same line of work, I see that he is really just simply dedicated to serving other people.
Biazon's widow, Monchi, meanwhile, says her late husband taught her to be strong.
I've been married 62 years now. And it's a long-lasting marriage. He taught me how to be strong. Not literally, but his examples. I really miss him. He's no longer in the den, in his sofa. Then I never hear the TV anymore. So it's sort of very hard to start.
Biazon will be interred at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani on June 20th. Before that, the Senate will hold a necrological service for him. The Philippine Marines also set to hold a public viewing for the former military man at its headquarters. For one of his former colleagues in the Senate, Biazon was a man who dedicated his life in defending the country's freedom and democracy. Former Senator Franklin Drilon says, from the military to the Senate, Biazon carried his patriotism with him. He recalled how the former senator called on government to defend the country's territorial rights way before China's aggression in Philippine waters.
In terms of our territorial dispute with China, for example, he was that was before the arbitral award, but he was already taking a position that we should never surrender an inch of our territory. So we have a patriot who left significantly on Independence Day, and indeed, we deeply mourn the passing of a soldier, of a general. As they say, you know, old soldiers never die. They just fade away.
The provincial government of Albay, meanwhile, braces for more evacuations as Mayon continues to show signs of unrest. So far, nearly 14,000 individuals have been moved to safety. But that number may rise if the evacuation order is expanded.
The 7-kilometer extended danger zone is a buffer zone that was established by the Philippine Institute of Volcanology, understanding that the hazards that are brought by the eruption, the materials ejected can reach as far as 6 to 7 kilometers. Yesterday, we issued a PDRRMC advisory informing all the residents to be in preparedness status mm-hmm. meaning that they should be ready anytime should evacuation will be executed. This is also in line with the FIBOX pronouncement mm-hmm. that the unpredictability of the Mayan volcano, the alert level may be raised anytime.
Meanwhile, Albay Governor Greg Slagman says some residents are still going back to their farmlands despite the entry ban.
Meron pa rin mga ilan-ilan na di natin pwede masisi na buwabalik sa kanilang mga farmlands para magpastol. Pero ito naman po ay laging may kaakibat na tulong ng ating mga authorities or persons in authority. Katulad po ng mga punong barangay. So, sila po yung bumabalik naman sa mga evacuation centers right after they do their business or work dun sa kanilang farmlands. Looking forward, kailangan talaga dito mabago na yung sistema sa Albay kasi ayaw namin maging perennial problem to na kada meron tayong ganito mga pagbabanta ng pagsabog ng Bulkang Mayon or anumang mga calamity. Evacuate na lang po kami ng evacuate doon po sa 6-kilometer danger zone. So it's about time that we sit down with all the mayors.
The Provincial Health Office of Albay preparing for a possible shortage of medical supplies amid Mayon's unrest. Provincial Health Officer Dr. Estelia Zenit says emergency medical supplies for evacuees have already been deployed to hospitals. She adds the Department of Health vows to provide more supplies to the province.
May mga na-point na po sila ng mga allocated funds. Nagre-reprogram na po ang province kung saan po namin pwedeng kunin pa yung ibang mga pangangailangan. Kasi ang PSWD nangangailangan din sa health. Nagre-reprogram na po sila ng disaster fund.
President Marcos approves the pilot implementation of the food stamp program. The pilot run will be fully funded by a nearly $3 million grant from the Asian Development Bank. A total of 3,000 families will be initially covered. But the program aims to help a million poor households in the country.
From the pilot, we will see the nuances. What needs to be improved, what needs to be enhanced, what needs to be discontinued. It'll run for 6 months. We are doing the pilot so that we don't end up with wasteful spending. We want to make sure that when we do expand the program on its regular run, even if the president already approved it, we want to learn from the pilot.
The program will now include pregnant and lactating mothers in a bid to also address the problem of stunting among Filipino children.
The president wanted a more cohesive approach to this problem of hunger and addressing the poor. And he was asking, I don't want duplication. Yun ang pinopose ko sa president. I think the way to approach this is a life stage. And umpisa doon sa buntis.
Over now to the COVID-19 front. An expert identifies some key concerns as the Philippines begins to move on from the pandemic. Dr. Guido David of the OCTA Research Group says the lack of healthcare workers and bivalent COVID vaccines in the Philippines are some of the major concerns in the country's pandemic exit plan.
Kahit na mababa yung cases, pag tumatas ng konti, mas madaling ma-burden yung mga hospitals natin compared to other countries dahil sila, they have enough healthcare workers. In fact, kinuha nila yung mga nurses natin. Doon nagpuntahan yung mga ating nurses. Isa pang challenge natin ay sa ibang bansa, meron na sila mga bivalent. In fact, meron na nga ang trivalent vaccines. Ito na yung latest sa, I think sa China siya na kunakita. Mm-hmm. So tayo, wala pa tayong bivalent. So may mga institutional challenges tayo that we have to address.
The Philippines received nearly 400,000 doses of donated bivalent vaccines from Lithuania earlier this month. No word yet on government's plan to procure more bivalent shots. Vice President Sara Duterte meets with the Crown Prince of Brunei. Duterte says they talked about sports and the contribution of Filipino workers in Brunei. She also invited Prince Haji Al-Mutadi Billah to the Philippines. Duterte, who is also the concurrent education secretary, is in Brunei to meet with officials of the Southeast Asian Ministers of Education Organization, or SAMEO, to examine strategies that could be used to further raise the quality of education in the region. The Philippine Vice President is serving as the head of the SAMEO Council. While in Brunei, she witnessed the signing of two vital partnerships between the University of Brunei Darussalam and the Philippine Normal University. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel appeals to the Toll Regulatory Board and the North Luzon Expressway Corporation to suspend the provisional increase in toll rates. Pimentel says a toll hike freeze will help ease the burden on Filipinos who are already struggling with high prices of goods. He adds any increase would also be unjustifiable since drivers also have to deal with very heavy traffic on the expressway, especially the Balintawak to Meycauayan stretch. The adjusted rates are set to take effect on June 15. There are an estimated 280,000 vehicles plying NLEX on a daily basis. Here's some good news for commuters. A new ride-hailing company is coming to Manila. California-based InDrive is looking to begin operating in the Philippines before the end of the year. It says it's just waiting for the green light from the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board. The company uses a slightly different model than rivals like Grab. It will allow drivers and commuters to negotiate the fare, with both having the freedom to accept or turn down the offer. The 11-year-old company is present in 47 countries, including Indonesia, Malaysia, and Vietnam. DNA samples obtained from the assassination of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo have matched three suspects who are currently under police custody. Degamo family's lawyer, Attorney Levito Baligod, says the National Bureau of Investigation has submitted the DNA analysis as evidence. This development was revealed during the first preliminary probe on the murder and frustrated murder complaints filed against suspended Negros Oriental Representative Arnolfo Teves Jr., the alleged mastermind of the killing. The probe was attended by the 10 suspects in the killing, as well as members of the Degamo family.
We have been telling the public that despite the recantation of the shooters, we assured everybody that we can still successfully prosecute these cases. We now have in our possession a copy of the DNA examination result conducted by the NBI over some specimen recovered doon sa sasakyan na ginamit ng mga bumaril. Nagmatch yung sample na nakuha doon sa sasakyan at saka yung nakuhang mga blood stains doon sa compound ni Governor Degamo. Dahil if you can recall, some of the shooters sustained gunshot wounds also.